Okay, I've assembled all my ingredients and put aside a separate portion because one of my children has a milk protein allergy, so she can't have the cheese or the cream of chicken soup. I'm just going to put a little black pepper in here, or maybe a lot, huh? And I'm just going to mix all this up together. It still looks a little dry, too. So this is the broccoli, the chicken, the chopped onions, the cheese, cream of chicken soup. You can use cream of mushroom, it doesn't matter. I'm about to sneeze because of the pepper. Hello. And I think I need a little more of this soup. Here's a tip. If you have to sneeze in the kitchen, turn away from the food and bend all the way down. And try to sneeze into your shoulder. I didn't make it into my shoulder that time. But if you bend down low, that should help a little bit. Too much pepper. Alright, I just used the whole can. You're only supposed to use like 2/3 of the can. Okay, so I've taken my crescent rolls. I've taken 1.5 packs and just arranged them with the broad side of the triangle down and just arranged them kind of in a circle. Now, I'm not really happy with the placement. I want to bring that in a little bit more. Ordinarily, I would do these on a round, just a round flat stone, but my oven isn't large enough to accommodate my stone. So I'm going to use this deep dish pie plate instead. And just going to take my scoop and place the mixture all the way around. Making sure everybody gets enough broccoli, chicken, cheese, etc. All the way around. And ordinarily, I would do an egg wash on the top, but I'm not going to do that today because what? My tiny cooktop oven is so close to the element, I don't want it to burn. So you see what I've done, I'm putting this all the way around in a circle. Hey, looks like there's more meat over there and not as much broccoli. Okay, so now comes the fun part. Actually, we don't want to waste anything. Put all that in there. Fresh cracked pepper tastes really good with this. I'm on a cayenne pepper kick, but I just use black pepper for this recipe today. Next, you're going to take the tip, the point of your triangle, and bring it in, tuck it under. You're going to do that all the way around. And I forgot to preheat my oven, so we're going to have to stop this when I'm done wrapping. And you can make it neater. This is kind of rustic. It's just family style tonight. But if it was for a party, I probably would be more careful. And this is great for brunch. Dinner, you could fill it with anything. You could use pizza dough and make your own calzones or your own fake hot pockets.
Hot pockets.
Alright, so I'm going to bake that, I think, what is it, 350 for 25 minutes. Okay.
Okay, so now I'm getting ready to put this in the oven.
I'll put it on
350.
and it's going to be in there for about 25 minutes. Okay, so I took it out of the oven. I had to cover it with an aluminum pan because I was out of tin foil. And you can probably hear it sizzling. Can you hear? So I'm going to let it rest a little bit before I cut it. But anyway, that's how it looks. And it's going to be good. And I can't wait. Thanks for watching. Bye.